Hello everyone, I welcome you all to the maths class. So in today's session we will be doing question number 7 from exercise 7.3, chapter number 7, fraction. Okay, so in this session what we are going to discuss about is to reduce the following fraction into the simplest form. So yesterday only we have done this sum also. The topic has been touched, but here we will be discussing about this in a more detailed manner. Reduce means the fraction which are given in the question are not in the simple form. That is, reducing means to convert the given fraction into the simple form. Suppose say 1 by 5 is already in a simple form. We cannot convert or we cannot reduce this into the simplest form. It is already in a reduced form. Why? Because we cannot have a cut. We cannot reduce this by any way. Suppose 5, if I cut this by 5, but we cannot cut 5 with, but we cannot cut 1 with 5. So that means this number or this fraction is already in a reduced form. Now, but 48 by 60, we have to reduce this into the simplest form by cutting 1 by 1 with the same numbers. Let's cut this with the first of all with 2. So 2 24 is 48, you all know. 2 2 is 4, 8 will be there down. 2 4 is 8. So what do you get? What are you getting? 24. Same number, that is, we have chosen 2. So 2 should divide this 60. 2 3 is 6, 2 0 is 0. So 2 30 is 60. So it's not like that. You are dividing with 2 in the 48, that is in numerator, and dividing denominator with different number. It cannot be done. So most of the student does that mistake also, that they do 2 24 is 48 and they divide 3 20 is 60. Cannot be done. So if you are dividing one number with 2, then another number should also be divided with 2. It cannot be divided with 3. Alright, same number should be divided. So same number should be chosen to divide both the number. Okay, next 2 12 are 24, 2 15 are 30. Now 3 4 are 12, 3 5 are 15. So both numbers should be divided in by the same number. So the reduced form of, so you will write reduced form or simplest form also you can write. Anyone you can choose. Simplest form of 48 by 60 is what? 4 by 5. Now after 4 by 5 we cannot have a cut. Just see, 2 to the 4 can be done, but 5 cannot be divided with 2. So this is the reduced form of the 48 and 60. Alright, let's head forward to the next one. 150 by 60. Very easy one. So we can have a cut of 0 0, because in both the numerator and denominator there is 0, so we can cut that. Now more can be deduced. Just see, 3 to the 6, 3 5 is a 15, so we have got the answer, that is 5 by 2 is the answer. So try to use the same number. Okay, not try to use, you have to compulsorily, you have to use the same number, and the thing is you have to make it very simple. So 5 by 2 is the simplest form of, simplest fractional form of 150 divided by 60. So 150 by 60 we have cut and we have divided into, converted into the simplest form, that is 5 by 2. Alright, the last number C we have is 84 divided by 98. So let's do it. 84 divided by 98. Okay, let's choose the smallest number, that is 2, to cut both the numbers. So 284, we have to divide this 84 by 2. 2 4 is 8. 2 2 is 4. So 2 42 is 84. Similarly, let's divide this 98 with the same number 2. 2 4 is 8. 1 2 9 is 18. So 2 49 is 98. Alright. So let me remove this. You can do this part in your rough work. So let's start again dividing with the 2. But you can see here 49 cannot be divided by 2, because as 9 is a, at the end of the digit, unit digit is odd number. So let's divide with 7. 7 6 are 42. 7 7 are 49 can be done. So our reduced form is the 6 by 7. So 6 by 7 is the simplest form of 84 by, simplest form of 84 divided by 98. Okay, very easy sum. Simple one. I hope you have understood this. So let's do the number D now. Number D I'm doing here. 12 by 52. 12 divided by 52. So we have to choose the same number, that is to cut both the numerator and denominator, don't get confused, to 6 is 12, 2, 26 is 52, right? Then 2, 3 is 6 can be done, 2, 13 is 26 can be done. So 3 by 13, therefore 3 by 13 is the simplest form of 12 by 52. So after reducing, finally we got 3 by 13. Both 3 and 13 cannot be deducted further. So now the last one, that is question number E, will be a home assignment. Okay, student. So I hope you have understood the concept. All right. So this much for today. In our next class, we will proceed with the next sum. Till then, stay safe and healthy. Thank you, everyone.